coaching, and now we're a real sense of deja vu for travel agents who are trying to reschedule the 400,000 bookings that they have carried over and were asked to reschedule last year. I want to bring in Pat Dawson, CEO of the Irish Travel Agents Association. Pat, what is going to happen with those 400,000 vaccines or 400,000 bookings?
I wish we had 400,000 vaccines.
Indeed.
Well, what's going to happen? We shifted those people from last year onto this year as such. And there was sort of free movement in the sense of they could move, but then airlines or whatever charged fees if the airfare was dearer. So many families paid 500-600 euros to change over. And now we're looking at the same situation happening again because, you know, at the best of with the wind behind us, we feel that, you know, if we get in the air September, October, we might be doing very well. But on that, I mean, and it's up in Matt's area, I mean, to realise that the north of Ireland are going to start flying extensive amount of people from the 17th of May. And you have Ryanair with 11 new flights out of Belfast. And there'll be thousands of people coming from the south up to the north to get out of there. So that's something that's on the horizon. And we spoke to Minister McGrath about that yesterday. So that's coming down the track. And we're wondering what's going to happen in that case.
You're concerned about airlines flying empty planes, these ghost flights that they fly so that they don't have to pay refunds.
Yes, and that happened an awful lot last year where the EU regulation means that if an airline or a cruise company cancels the flight, EU 261 gets you a full refund. But because airlines were so fully booked, particularly in the high season, 80-90% full, if they cancelled, they would have to refund. So they flew the aircraft, they kept the people's money, but the government was saying to the public, you cannot fly. This is an intolerable situation on the consumer. We've asked Transport to look at it. You know, when the government can cancel flights over the Christmas period, surely to God, if the government is saying you cannot fly, the airlines should be forced to cancel the aircraft and refund people their money.
And just in relation to then the vaccine digital green pass that's being proposed at European level, I see Spain, I'm looking at headlines here, that Spain could be ready to start rolling out a vaccine passport by the end of May, which would pave the way to holidaymakers coming back into that country. Do you have any sense that we could be seeing a pass that could allow people to travel more freely?
Oh, I do. I do indeed. And we're members of ECTA, the European Travel Agents, and they have a 4-point plan for recovery, travel restrictions, vaccinations and health certificates and testing. And they're all in hand. And I suppose we're saying to the government, please have a plan in front of us.
What's the government saying to you, though? What did Michael McGrath have to say about that?
Michael McGrath said that the Department of Transport and Health will discuss that. It wasn't high on the agenda as such, but I think we need to start that conversation, or should have started that conversation some months ago, because after all, there are 400,000 jobs depending on the inbound and the outbound of people, because without travel agents booking the outbound, the inbound will suffer and vice versa.